Good morning. I had an awesome night last night. I was just out like a rock. Slept really well up here. And it did not freeze. It's probably right at 32 degrees. It's definitely cold, but stuff didn't freeze. Sun's up nice and early. I think the sun started coming up at like 5:30, and that's kind of a first for me. Usually I'm lower in a valley or somewhere where I don't see the sun for a couple of hours worth of hiking. But we're gonna have a beautiful start to the day. It's gonna be a short, quick day. We're only doing like 15 miles. The goal is to get to this some kind of warming hut cabin that's maintained by like a local ski lodge or something like that. So it should have a wood-burning furnace, lots of wood. Reviews say it's an awesome place to stay, and that'll stay just perfect for getting into Monarch Pass tomorrow around noon. So that is the goal for today. Let's get started.
Totally clear skies this morning. Beautiful mountain skyline. That tallest one out there, that's Mount Ouray. We're gonna end up in the foothills there tonight. That one's just shy of 14,000. This is Tank 7 Creek. I think water's gonna be pretty scarce again today, but I think that our cabin destination is gonna have a water source. I was just double checking the maps. It looks like we're following the little creek here for about 2 miles. That'll be our last opportunity to collect water. And then we got up on ridges, similar to yesterday, and no water until we get to our destination for tonight. If I was a moose, this is where I'd be hanging out. There's some reasonably fresh moose tracks in the trail. Need to see some more moose. There's an old broken down shack right here, and there's a marmot sitting on top, keeping watch and sounding the alarm, squeaking at me. Since we camped kind of at the top of a mountain yesterday, it's all been a cruisy downhill this morning, but we do have at least one big uphill coming later. But in general, I think the terrain looked pretty mild overall. There's our junction. We're at the bottom of the valley. We got a little bit of a hill climb to get back up on the ridges. This is our last opportunity for water till we get to the cabin. And we're saying goodbye to Tank 7 Creek here, so I'm gonna fill up, and then we'll be on our way. That's still a very rocky trail. Made it to the top of the ridge. Gonna be relatively smooth for a little bit, and then we got a major climb coming in a couple of miles. There's a squirrel eating snow. Must be thirsty. Beautiful section of aspen forest, the way the sun is kind of glowing through the trees. Very pretty. This is just a quarter mile down trail later, and the forest is totally different. I kind of like seeing changes like this. I've said it before, every forest is totally different and every other forest I've hiked through. I think somebody's been eating a little too many pine cones. There's been a few small snow patches in this section, but in general, it's been really awesome to be out of the snow for a bit. I think in and around Monarch Pass and north of it, it's still kind of moderately mild to heavy snow. I'm gonna have to do a lot more research on snow conditions once we get to Salida. A lot of little uphill climbs for the day, but they're kind of short and steep. Finally got a bit of a view for a change. And I'll point out some landmarks we got coming up. We'll be going up to the top of there. This is gonna be the big climb of the day. That's Windy Peak. And then we're down the backside. And we're gonna be over in the foothills of that mountain. That's Mount Ouray. And that's where we're gonna end up for tonight, down at the base there somewhere. We've started the climb up to Windy Peak. I'm sure it'll be getting steeper. And on a side note, the mosquitoes are out. I've been noticing them for the last few days. They're not too aggressive though. I haven't been bit by one yet. Yeah, there's some steep parts. Trail Junction here, Marshall Pass, 6.5 miles. I think that's where I'm staying tonight, or it's where the cabin is. So today is a short day, only 6.5 miles left. Steeper and rockier. Well, I think we're just about as high as the trail gets up Windy Peak. The summit of it is up that way. But we got that climb over with. That was definitely a struggle. Now we're back to just bouncing between the peaks. Well, we've hit that point of sketchy snow embankments again. And now we got muddy snowmelt trail. Oh, very muddy. There's Mount Ouray, getting closer to where we're gonna end up for tonight. And just wanna take a minute to appreciate the gorgeous weather. Not a single cloud, totally blue skies. I think we may have a trend to where the rainy, stormy, snowing, hail, freezing rain, those days may be over, hopefully.
I'm stopped for a lunch break. It's about noon. We only got 4 miles left. So I'm taking my time and we'll be back on trail whenever.
Colorado is definitely much more enjoyable when you're not risking your life on snow traversals or freezing to death in snowstorms. This is much better. Those last couple miles flew by, relatively easy terrain, but we made it to Marshall Pass. Big parking lot down there, right at the base of Mount Ouray. And I think from here, up a little side dirt road, should be the cabin we're looking for. Maybe just a quarter mile away or so. So we'll see you there. We made it to home for the night. Very nice little cabin. Public use. maintained by Heart of the Rockies Snowmobile Club, had a Salida. Awesome. Show you the inside in a second. We got a nice little stream just over here. Fire pit, bench, picnic table outside. Now let's take a look inside. We've got tons of stacked firewood. Three cots. Put more people on the floor in the middle. And a large wood-burning stove. I think I might be firing this up later tonight. I know of like two hikers that were around me, but I think they're ahead of me, looking to get into town, like either later tonight or like very first thing in the morning. I don't know if anybody's gonna join me in here. It'd be kinda cool if I'm all alone.
Well, I'm getting settled in nicely. I'm just gonna be totally relaxing for a while. I'm here super early. It's like 1:45. I got plenty of water. I got plenty of snacks. I'm gonna be eating and drinking, just relaxing. I'll probably just check back in later once I'm cooking up my dinner or something.
I've got two deer visitors hanging around the cabin.
Well, it's coming up on dinner time, so I'll show you what I got here. This is what I've been having the last couple days. Got my instant mashed potatoes. I'll be boiling up some water for that here in a minute. Tuna packets and Spam. I got some good ones here, found in the last resupply run. 140 calories. These are the ones in sunflower oil. These are pretty rare to find in hiker towns, and you can find some in olive oil as well. Those are even more rare. A good old packet of Spam. These things are 230 calories, so that's pretty good. Also pretty rare to find these things in hiker towns. They get snatched up pretty quick. I'll start cooking this up. Well, I think we'll go ahead and close out the day. It is a lot warmer in the evening here than what we thought, so we're not firing up the stove anytime soon. We'll see if it gets to freezing overnight, and if we need to, we'll fire it up. But I got one other person that came on in, so I'm not alone in the cabin here. Otherwise, I think that's going to do it for tonight, so in the morning, we only got the 10 miles to hike in to Monarch Pass, and then we'll start hitching into town. So that's going to do it. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you all in the morning. Good morning. Heading out of the cabin. Getting to town today through Monarch Pass. About 10 miles. And had a decent night last night. It stayed warm enough where we didn't need to fire up the stove. I was kind of looking forward to have that wood burning, but it would have been way too hot. And it's actually not that cold this morning. Maybe only 40 degrees as opposed to like 20 degrees. But let's see, the only other thing was there was one mouse critter in there scurrying around all night. I don't think he chewed any holes in any of my stuff, but I haven't really taken a good look. But anyway, that's that. So I think we start out with an uphill, get back on some ridges. This might be a stretch where there's more snow, might be more sketchy. We'll just kind of see how it goes once we get up there.
Starting out the hill climb on a dirt road. This is kind of a long uphill, but it's gradual, so it's been not too bad so far. There's some noticing more animal tracks. That's probably another wolf. Big prints. The next snow-capped mountain range off in the distance should be the Collegiates. That'll be the next group to tackle. Lots of snow out there still. Part of my replanning decisions. Kind of cold and windy today. The sun's up behind the mountains still. It's gonna take a while before we get warmed up by it. Thank you. There's a decent bit of post-holing going on some of these snow patches. Nothing too crazy difficult, though. There's looking back. Last mile or so has been really rough. No trail, just bushwhacking it through forest of snow. There's a little cornice ridge. We gotta go up and over that. Kinda right where the trees are blocking. That's where the trail goes, so I'll see you up there. That's a bad looking cornice. We're going up. Right in there, should be a better spot. That's a fun view. Where I'm standing is less dangerous than it looks. Oh, the trail coming up looks easier for a little bit at least. Going across there, disappearing over the next ridge. Big trail junction here. This is where the Colorado Trail splits in half. There's the Collegiate East and West. The West stays high up in the mountains, and that's where the Continental Divide Trail is supposed to go. Collegiate East is the low route through the valleys and kind of dips down that way, and that's where that starts. But we're gonna stay on the Collegiate West / Continental Divide to Monarch Pass, continuing this way. Trail's down there a bit, cuts through another big snow berm. I'm doing the up and around. We'll catch back up on the other side. Cutting through the mountain is the highway, Highway 50. That's the one we're gonna take to town. And Monarch Pass is just a little bit out of view around the corner behind the mountain there. I think we're getting into the last descent down to the pass. Looks like another big snow berm to go over. Looks like there's foot tracks. Everybody's just kind of going over this one, so maybe it's not too bad. First view, Monarch Pass. Big parking lot down there. There's our goal for the day. More snow. More slow going snow berms to get through in the last 2 miles or so. Oh, the trail's getting nicer now. Less than a mile to the pass. Okay, we're just about there. Monarch Pass. First thing is gonna be to find the little eatery. I don't think it's too fancy of like a full restaurant, but apparently you can get like hamburgers and hot dogs and chips and sodas and things like that. So I'm just gonna sit down and eat as much as I can. I'm in no rush. Can't check into the hotel until like the afternoon anyway, and it's like 10:30, and I am super hungry, so I'm gonna take my time. I missed my usual chance to get second breakfast because up on the ridges the wind chill factor was just so super cold I couldn't stop, had to keep moving. So we'll be up here in just a little bit. Here we go. I just got my food ordered. Got a little burger, cup of chili, soda. There's not really a lot of people here right now, but here's kind of what the food area looks like. We got a little gear shop. There's some resupply options. I'll kind of take some clips around. Lots of space to chill. It's almost like you don't even have to go to town.
You want a bit from the cyber drive?
Lots of gear stuff. And back in the corner here, there is a secret designated hiker chill space. So this little cubby room is kind of just for hikers. You can just chill and relax and have a little peaceful moment to yourself. So I'm gonna go back to food. Let's get some lunch going.
Well, I've been chilling here at Monarch Pass for like the last 4 hours, getting a lot of work done. I've eaten my fill, I've had lots to drink, and Wi-Fi here is pretty good, so I've gotten all my videos uploaded. So I think it's about time where we can start hitching and trying to get to town. I think it's about 3 o'clock, so that'll be the next task. Hopefully, we'll see you guys in Salida here shortly. We made it to town. Took about 10 minutes, got a hitch from one of the girls who was working there at the Monarch Pass rest stop facilities, whatever you call it. She was just getting off shift and picked me up, so that was awesome. I am at the Loyal Duke Lodge, so I think this is a good location, kind of not in the center of town, but more so on like the west side of town, near-ish to the Walmart and some restaurant locations, so I'm gonna get cleaned up. I don't need food or anything right away. I got most of my electronic need chores done because I got videos uploaded while we were at the pass, so I'm just gonna reorganize stuff. I gotta do laundry. I think they have coin laundry here, and maybe that's all I'm gonna be up to for today. I'm gonna do more planning and resupply and all that tomorrow for the zero day, so I'll check back later once I'm all cleaned up and we'll figure out what we're doing for the next bit. Well, it's been a little bit, and we got a lot accomplished. I'm all showered and cleaned up. We got laundry done. They got coin laundry facilities here, and a couple days ago I mentioned one of my micro spikes was broken, so they had some pliers at the front desk, and I was able to just kind of pinch the linkages back together. So we got that fixed. So now it is dinner time, and I've noted there's a Peruvian restaurant about a half a mile down the road, so that sounds awesome to me. So let's go walk down and get some Peruvian dinner tonight.
This is the place, Yunza Peruvian Cuisine. Here's the main course for dinner.
Back in the hotel room and totally stuffed. That was an excellent dinner. And I really wanted to try the dessert, but I was so full, but I got the dessert to go anyway. So I got like this banana cake thing that I'm gonna have later, and that's gonna go down awesome. Whew, I think that's it for now. As I've said before, it's always a huge de-stressor when you get the majority of your chores done as soon as you get to town. So I got all my videos uploaded when I was back at Monarch Pass, so that was awesome. We got laundry done. All I gotta do tomorrow is figure out what route I'm officially gonna take. Do I go back up into the snowy mountains, or do we take a low route? So we'll figure that out tomorrow, and then we'll do the resupply run accordingly. So, that's it. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you all tomorrow.